Bertrand's ballot theorem tells us the odds that the winner of an election was always ahead in the vote count. Here's the setup. There are two candidates, Alice, who gets P% of the vote, and Bob, who gets Q%. For the sake of simplicity, we assume that P is greater than Q. That is, Alice wins. The votes come in a random order, and we keep a running tally of the vote counts. What are the odds that the running tally will have always said that Alice is ahead? Remarkably, the answer is incredibly simple. There's a P-Q% chance that Alice will have always been ahead. What surprises me about this fact is that it doesn't depend on how many votes get cast and only on the percentages. On top of this, it has an incredibly clever proof. Start counting the votes one at a time. If it's for Alice, take a step up, and if it's for Bob, take a step down. The good paths, that is, paths where Alice is always winning, stay above the x-axis. And the bad paths at some point touch the x-axis. We want the proportion of good paths, or equivalently, 1 minus the proportion of bad paths. For every bad path, take the part up until the first time it touches the x-axis, and flip it. This process mashes up bad paths that start with Alice winning and bad paths that start with Bob winning, so exactly half the bad paths start with Bob winning. But any path that starts with a Bob vote is a bad path, and there's a Q% chance that our first vote is a Bob vote. Then 2Q% of all paths are bad paths, and with a little algebra, we get that P minus Q% of all paths are good paths, finishing the proof.